Praise King Selassie. Speaking about race, racism, other communication channel networks picked up on this, been talking about it for decades. Probably talk about it for decades to come. Doesn't seem to be a solution, although that's part of the operation, you know, bring the new generations in. Pedophile repulses everyone. Man tamed by the beast. The institution become gods. And that whole framework, you know, exists to propagate the Antichrist. This is sowing seeds of division amongst people. Very, very rarely are people willing to examine the underlying reason for this division. What's behind it? Why are people racist? This is not a simple matter. It is man-made. So it is complex. It takes time. There's many components. The main result is a division. If I'm fighting with my neighbor, yeah, then I don't have time to fight with anyone else. The fact is that there's a few people that own most of the so-called wealth. And they do it because they designed a structure of law. Yeah. Spread out amongst the nations that confine people to this. System. And it works for them. Benefit. If those that do most of the serving are continuously conflicting with one another, they will perceive their brother to be their enemy and expound most of their energy to dissolve these pains. And yet, this is fabrication, because it is almost as if, you know, you complain to the cashier or the customer service representative on the phone about the services of the company, when this person has no control. They're simply there to take calls or take orders. And if your hamburger comes out and it's not cooked right, it wasn't their fault. So, as in the Tower of Babel being symbolic of the man-made construct, there are layers, levels, and these form barricades in between those that have most of the wealth, everyone else. It's not, this part is not difficult to comprehend. Yet people have to remind themselves, because there is warfare that is acting to manipulate the minds to believe that these enemies, the oppressing classes, are idols, gods, people to be looked up to. They deserve to be in that position. When you think about how these people attained their status, you know they did it unjustly. even though they were the ones that wrote most of the history, their deceit is not undetected. Fast forward to today. Everybody's at war. On the screen, let's say. But these divisions are fabricated to give people a challenge, an opponent, something to fight against, something to stand up for. These battles are being chosen for people. When, if people, you know, discarded all that garbage information, began to process reality, may come to determine there is a possible solution, and it ain't in the direction that's been chosen for us. Regardless of what you think about someone else because of some personal experience you may have had, there is benefits to be had for you, so long as you can co-join with your common foe in an effort of common interest. You hear the tools, they're on the radio, they're on the television, they're on the smart devices. And they always act like your friend. But they're always painting these perceptions to make people believe. Here's what it is, the white man or something is losing this position. He's angry. The black man is sexually intolerant, whatever. Because, these perceptions are easy to sell to them because they're propagating the images. For example, you have the pornography, you have the dark skins gangbanging on the white one, and then you get, a Dylann Roof type. Because this is what he's seeing, and he's saying, well, this is what is real, what's going on. So it's not a coincidence. This culture that's magnified through these devices to have this outcome. And it benefits those. If it didn't, it wouldn't be happening. The African slave trade is the cause of so many woes to so many people for so many years. It continues to cause harmful consequences upon populations of every country involved. No one is held accountable. Don't you think that those in positions of royalty in these European nations have not or have benefited? Reality is beckoning. We call. These people are master manipulators at selling themselves. And They've perfected this art. People remember this because it's easy to give in. Well, they're not so bad. Look at them. Look at. Think about the worst kind of atrocity that may have occurred in recent times. You've got young adults, children, cutting, severing heads from shoulders. You have the mercenaries, gang raping mothers in front of their children and their children as well, and live stream. The list goes on, right? It could, don't you think? These things didn't happen before. The objective is to paint the perception. These folks are uncivilized. They're part of some kind of other system. They need to get in line. We're going to send some military over there to civilize these folks. Truth is far from that line. Colonization, enslavement, bondage. People can look at dark-skinned populations today and say, well, they haven't achieved much success, so we must have gone the high road, because if we had given the power to these folks, then everybody would be living in a ghetto. What the man doesn't take into consideration is that violence is perpetrated on people that were nonviolent. And so therefore the nonviolent were overtaken and forced into bondage to do all the work for the oppressor, the violent. So because people choose to be nonviolent, they deserve to serve others. They are not superior to others. Now, that's a perception, that this man has believed in. And yet, if those civilizations had continued disrupted, even if there was a social economy, how would that compare? It's hypothetical, because the man has chosen his way over I way. I way. And so it will most likely be that man will never know. Has a need now to sell this, otherwise he loses his position. He's using his tools, mouthpieces. They're working through those institutions, NCAA, what have you. Now, these institutions, just as many of the so-called Christian churches, have done some good. But overall, express falsehood. To make people think they are going to have a stake in their life. As long as they put faith in those institutions. pretend that they got something going. It's their decision. My men don't like to pretend. Just integrate. That's their plan. Just, you come in, run for the office, write your representative. You get caught up in these petty paths that lead
to Gehenna.
Examine the underlying causes of these divisions amongst people. Find out. It benefits some. That's why the communication channel networks spend so much time. And you hear them say things like, oh, this is the issue that the Americans waste so much, the most time on. Yeah, waste the most time because you keep talking about it.
It's going to Gehenna.
You're gonna have certain people integrate, and you're gonna have some people not integrate. It's perfect for those. It's not only have you divided the neighbor against each other, but the neighborhood against each other. Some people say, you know, this is what black looks like. Gang bang, making money, you know, big pimping, spending cheese. Got, you know, cash rules everything around me. Cream get the money. Dollar. The CIA, these intelligence agencies, I don't even want to use the word CIA because that's what it is a scapegoat. CIA, the CIA, the CIA. And everybody says, oh, it's the CIA. It doesn't matter what they do. You know what I'm saying? But they're intelligence agencies. You know, they make pretend that they're, you know, crocodile hunters and jumping off of James Bond space shuttle somewhere, you know, doing some wild thing. No, okay? They exist. Like, for instance, the United States of Pedophiles, the CIA was originally the Office of Secret Service, and the purpose is to promote the dollar. I mean, doesn't that make sense? Who are you going to have promote it if you don't have the intelligence agency that's not supposed to work domestically? You know what I'm saying? But all these intelligence agencies work as a giant network, a behemoth of industry to promote the flow of commerce, which is exchange. Facts and pockets. Duh. You know, the banks, they can't go around promoting the dollar. All they do is exchange it, collect interest. That's what happens. So, when you have this kind of music, it's being put on. Even these people, these cats, they might not know it because they're living in their own little fantasy, you know, it's been given to them. They sitting up pretty, you know, they deserved it and it was God's gift to them, you know. Okay, so, but the management, the connections. You had the case in Cuba that was Alto or whatever, and, you know, some rapper, and it was the CIA who was paying his manager. So, if the CIA here doing it, don't you think the British are doing it? The British are a fifth the size of the population, maybe less, the United States pedophiles. And yet, they have a higher level of security, as evident by their G, the NSA over there, GCHQ. You know, it's larger than the NSA. It's like an intelligence agency. I mean, that's where it spawns from. The USP is mostly just a vehicle for some of these wealthiest investors. It functions on their behest through the military. You can have an uprising. The military is going to take over because it's international powers that rule. They're going to make sure that those on the bottom serve them.